Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. For class 6 computer science, we were doing Microsoft Excel data formatting. This is basically your chapter number 2. The next topic is alignment and orientation. Alignment and orientation is basically related to the setting of the text or the position of the text in a cell. So what we have to do, we have to understand these two options. Okay, basically what does it mean when we say alignment? I am going to write over here, good. Better. Best. All these three words that I have mentioned are basically left aligned. How I will say these are left aligned? Align means ki these are on the left side of this cell. Basically, these are the options which are used for alignment. These are the options that we use for the alignment. If I increase the width of this cell by picking it from this line, I can increase the width of the row. So these are the three words which are basically by default on the left side. Means okay, this is on the left side, this is the option. Now if I select this word and I click central align, so you will see that the good has come in the center of the column. So it basically, these are the three options: left align, central align, and right align. So let's suppose if I apply left align to good, central align to better, and right align to best, then we can see the difference between these three alignment options. These options are related to left, right, and center. These are the options which are related to left, right, and center. So over here, we have applied these three options. Now it depends on our requirement. Okay, we are asked to make central align, then we will apply central align. We have been asked for the left align, we will apply the left align. Right align option is there. Now you will see these options are also there: top align, middle align, and bottom align. These are the three options available over here. What are the differences between these three options? Now we have to explore this thing. If I click on the good and I click on top align, it will go at the top in the same cell. It will be aligned at the top, and it is already aligned with the left. So it will be aligned at the top. It will go to the top. If I click the better option and I go to middle align, it will come in the middle. And if I click the best option, then I click on the bottom align, it is already in the bottom, so no change is there because it is already in the bottom. If it was at the top and I click on the bottom, it will click in the bottom. So whatever the text is given to us, let's suppose P1C, P1B, P1A. These are the three classes I have mentioned. I increase the width of the row so that we can see. I click on it, I say top align, I click on it, I say middle align, I click on it, and I say bottom align. It's up to us. If I click on it, if I say bottom align, if I click on it, if I say top align, if I click on it, if I say middle align, so it will come in the middle. So basically it depends on our requirement. Okay, what is basically our requirement? If in your question paper, in your lab activity, it is given that you have to apply top align or middle align or bottom align, so you have to apply these options in this way. This is very convenient, there isn't any problem in it. Now another option that we need to understand is basically orientation. What is meant by the orientation? I am going to write the text over here, P1C. Okay, we start from the P1A, P1B, and P1C. I take another one. Let's suppose 6C. Okay. So these are the four text options available. I increase the width of the row so that we can see the orientation clearly. Okay, what is meant by actually orientation? Orientation basically refers to the position of the text, whether it is on which angle, angular position of the text. So right now this is in a normal position. If I click on P1A and go to format option, format cells. In the format cell, you will see this option of orientation, which shows you the angular position of the text, the angular position of the text. Let's suppose if I give P1A, right now P1A is selected, so I am going to apply on P1A. And over here, I will bring the mouse cursor over here and I will pick it from there and go to the 90 degree and will click OK. Now the degrees you can see over here, it is on 90 degree. So now the P1A is there in the cell at 90 degree. P1A is at 90 degree. P is at the bottom, then 1, then A, means text is basically coming from the bottom to top. This is called 90 degree. Now, if I select the second cell, again, I go to the format option, format cells, and I select, let's suppose, this minus 90 degree. Basically over here it is in minus because we have reversed the position, and press OK. Now you can see that P is at the top and then 1 and B. So this is at minus 90 degree, P1B. So this is another orientation that we can apply on the text according to our requirement. Now I select P1C and go to format, format cells option. And let's suppose I apply this option, which is basically anti-clock angular direction. I go there and I apply 45 degree and click OK. Now you can see that P1C is at 45 degree, which is basically counterclockwise. It is not clockwise, it is counterclockwise. Now, if I select this 6C and go to the format option and format cells, and I apply over here minus 45 degree, this is clockwise. This direction is now basically clockwise, and now 6C is there in the clockwise position, which is basically an inclined position. Both are inclined positions, clockwise and anti-clockwise. And on which angle we want to change, it's also depend on us, okay, what is basically our requirement to change the orientation. So we can change the orientation of the text according to given angular position. So this is basically the theme of this lesson. Okay, you have to understand two important things. Number one, what is meant by the alignment, and number two, what is meant by the orientation of the text in a cell. I hope after going through this video again and again, you will be able to apply these options quite easily.